Get ready to match the stars. Avery Shriver, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Barbara Rose, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Reimer.
Thank you, Johnny Olson and friends
who are gathered here today.
Nice bunch, right? Got a nice bunch there and a dandy bunch up here.
Yes, I've been called many things.
You're all beautiful and gifted people.
It's excellent color combination.
Thank you. You see, there's just a slight hint of orange stripe in the suit.
And lovely.
Dayton Anderson figured a little orange from here would... am I an ensemble?
Very nice.
Thank you.
Ensemble.
Dayton Anderson.
Well, you just dropped a name, Kat. We know
I thought everybody knew who Dayton Anderson was.
Who is Dayton?
I don't know. No,
Dayton Anderson
is... that person that spends all his time in your dressing room.
That's right. He puts all of my outfits together, and he's a very gifted guy. Let's say hello to Pat Geyer now and to Christy Piper. Applause, applause, applause. Pat is our current champ. She has $2,850. That makes her very happy. Her home is Denver, Colorado, right?
Right.
Now, here is Christy Piper, who's had her first round question match one of our celebrities. Are you ready for to carry
ready.
On here? Okay, we'll see how this game turns out after we do a little business with you. Here we go. Boing, boing. Now, this is the other round one question. She had hers yesterday, or whenever it was, and Pat Geyer, this is yours. Did you hear about the mad scientist who crossed a greyhound dog with a greyhound bus?
No.
Shall I tell you about it?
You think he was mad?
Now he has the world's only greyhound dog with a blank. Crossed a greyhound dog with a greyhound bus. Now he has the only world's only greyhound dog with a blank.
Got it.
I will adjust my microphone cable while I'm waiting. Why do I have to have this big, heavy coupling that I'm dragging around with me now? You never used to have that here. Mark Breslow, why is that? Tell me. I want an explanation immediately. I don't like to carry all of this junk around with me.
You don't have to, sweetheart. You can quit.
I'm a very mobile person. All right. Now, Pat Geyer, did you hear about the mad scientist who crossed a greyhound dog with a greyhound bus? Well, now he has the world's only greyhound dog with a blank.
Driver?
Greyhound driver. Dog with a driver. Okay.
I'm torn.
They're not too thrilled with her answer. What have you got?
Well, I've got the only greyhound dog with a John in the back.
With a John. What do you say?
I said motor.
The world's only greyhound dog with a motor.
You don't like that?
That's not bad.
Well, you have to make some comment or else I feel rejected.
Okay.
Motor.
Not bad.
Thank you.
Right. What does it say there, Charles?
Dayton Anderson quits CBS Network.
Why?
Because of the insult of Miss Betty White on nationwide television, he has gone to work for Peter Marshall at another network. And he says that dressing Mr. Rayburn was not as easy as it appeared. His body was slightly on the weird side. Well, look at these things
doesn't
happen
say any of that in here. You rat.
Too long, I'll cut it tomorrow. Annex. He had an exhaust pipe, you know where.
Now he has the world's only greyhound dog with an exhaust pipe, you know where.
Is that what I have to match?
No, you got to match the answer that Pat said, which was driver.
Oh, well, I said restroom.
Restroom, right. So far we have two of those. Yes. Now, what do you offer?
Another restroom.
Oh.
That's two restrooms.
That's three.
One for men and one for women.
Yes.
One for dogs.
And one for dogs, right.
I love Dayton Anderson. I just got mixed up. It's you who wear Brett's clothes. I can't help getting mixed up like
that. Oh, no, no, I don't wear clothes. Well, once in a while I slip on a bra or something like that, but
no. No, greyhounds are known for their speed, so I said with a speedometer.
speed. The world's only greyhound dog with a speedometer. Very good answer there.
Wrong.
Why is that better than motor?
Well, because, you know, as she said, greyhound dogs are known for their speed. I don't know. Don't ask me to lead some logic into this whole mess. Here's the second and final round. 1-0 to score in favor of the challenger. Christy, you may have A or B.
A, please.
A. That's this one, the triangular one. Right. Bonnie said, let me tell you about my plumber. He's so mean, when I didn't pay my bill, he sent over two guys and they blanked my toilet. That's how mean he is. Didn't pay my bill, sent over two guys, they blanked my toilet.
Let me see.
Here you go.
Well, there's no answer to that, is there?
No comments.
Oh, that happened to me.
All right, here we go. Christy Piper. Bonnie said, let me tell you about my plumber. He's so mean. When I didn't pay my bill, he sent over two guys and they blanked my toilet.
Took out.
Took out my toilet.
Mm-hmm.
Do not be too hasty. Some of the weirdos might have said the same thing. All right, Avery.
He was so mean. This never happened to me, Charles. He plugged my toilet.
Plugged the toilet.
Yeah, my toilet will be on January 17th.
What do you say?
Stepped up. Stopped up my toilet.
Stopped up there. It's two of those. She's looking for a removal, total removal.
God, you're cold and hard. Closed.
Closed. Okay. None there. Yeah. All right, Christy, let's see what we get for you down here. Took out was her response, Barbara.
No, they clogged it.
Clogged it up. I didn't pay my bill. He sent over two guys, and they took out my toilet.
They plugged it.
Oh, they plugged it. Okay, bang.
They shot him.
So there we are. Yes. Now, when we come back from this commercial, all you have to do is match one to tie and two to win. Let's see how this game ends after this. You caught me unawares there. Now, let's finish. Pat, are you ready?
Ready.
All right, listen carefully. Now, one to tie and two to win. On the chain gang, when Christmas came around, Muggsy the convict didn't have a stocking, so he hung his blank over the fireplace. On the chain gang, when Christmas came around, Muggsy the convict didn't have a stocking, so he hung his blank over the fireplace.
That's a very moving story.
Yes, it is.
Sweet.
Right. Okay.
I'm finished.
Good.
Gee, I don't know. Can you...
Get away.
That's fine. Right. Oh, here we go. And now we come to Pat Geyer. On the chain gang, when Christmas came around, Muggsy the convict didn't have a stocking, so he hung his blank over the fireplace.
Ball.
Ball. All right. Yes.
Chestnuts roasting.
There it is. Tie score. One more, and she wins the game.
Well, I've never been in a chain gang, so I don't have a ball. But that's what I am.
That wins the game. Let's run to the game. Okay, Crystal Piper, you have a grand total of $7,600, which you won your previous appearance here, and I'm glad you had the chance to come back
yes.
here and meet
Thank
us
you.
Once again. Christy
Thank
Piper,
you very
ladies
much.
And gentlemen.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Okay. Now, Pat, this is your second trip up here. You know how it goes, so let's get right to it. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Duke of Blank. Remember, now you get $500 if you match the answer they gave most frequently. For matching the second most popular answer, you get $250. And then for matching the third most popular answer, you get $100. Three of our six celebrities will help you.
Barbara?
Oh, how about the Duke of Kent?
The Duke of Kent?
Yes.
Oh, I knew her well.
Avery?
The Duke of Earl.
The Duke of Earl.
Charles?
Thanks, baby.
Nothing, hon.
I would have never known. We can't let this be showing all the time to the nation. Duke of Windsor.
Duke of Windsor. So there you have the Duke of Earl, the Duke of Kent, and the Duke of Windsor. Remember again your option here. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own.
My first thought was Earl.
The Duke of Earl. Okay. All right. That was a song, right?
Yes.
Right.
I remember.
No? Well, the Earl of Sandwich is the one reputedly who invented the sandwich. But I don't know. I don't know what's going to be up there. This is a very interesting one to me. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal a $100 response. Duke of Wellington. Oh, listen. He was very big for a while there, but now who remembers him?
Indeed.
May we see the $250 response? Duke of Windsor is the answer that came up there from Charles. Last chance for the Duke of Earl. Here we go. Earl, you got it. You know what that means? You're playing for the big one, $5,000. We want to give you that money again, Pat, but you got to match one exactly. You got to choose one now.
My friend Richard.
Okay.
Duke of Edinburgh.
Duke of Edinburgh. I'm sorry, you're just one step behind us, sir. Would you march a little faster? We must all march to the same drummer here, Stan.
Royal blood, you know.
What's that, sir?
It's royal blood.
It's royal, oh, of course.
Nine generations.
Yeah.
Just
good luck.
Dash of Viking.
Ready? Blank. Sausage. Blank sausage. Blank sausage. Blank sausage. Hey, ready, Pat? What do you say to that? To match him and collect that $5,000. Blank sausage.
Pork.
Pork sausage. I don't know. They're not sure. Because we really didn't get much of a response from them. Richard, she says pork sausage will match you.
No, I thought of Polish sausage.
Polish sausage. Very good.
And
I was trying to think of it, but I couldn't remember it. There. Anyway, Pat, you've got $3,450 as a total at this moment. And we're going to meet another player in a moment. But right now, we want to do a little business with America.
Today's consolation prizes are first. A Master Mechanic shop vac picks up water or dry materials inside or out. Master Mechanic shop vac exclusively from True Value Hardware Store. And a warming tray and a supply of Golden Grain macaroni and cheddar dinners with enriched elbow macaroni and creamier cheddar cheese from Golden Grain. And an assortment of exciting Maybelline eye, face, and nail cosmetics featuring new nail color that decks and colors nails instantly by Maybelline. And a radio and a supply of Blue Ribbon Colossal Pistachios grown in California, sweeter and larger. It's the love nut. Colossal Pistachios Blue Ribbon is nuts. So let's laugh again with Gene Raver.
Okay, Johnny Olson, thank you. Let's all welcome Joe Kennedy.
Hey, Joe.
Oh, where are you from, Joe?
I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada. I deal poker there.
You deal poker?
Yes.
They're in here.
Oh, they're in there. I see. Okay. You've been doing that a long time?
28 years.
What is a cardinal rule for a good poker player to remember?
Play very seldom.
That's right.
No, that's true.
A good poker player will play only one of every five or six hands, won't he? He'll fold more often, won't he?
Oh, much more than one out of five or six.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Right. If you play three hands an hour, you're lucky.
No kidding.
Yeah, if you're playing no limit. Now, if you're playing limit for matches, who cares? You play every hand.
Yeah. Now, the odds are with the house, aren't they?
The house does not participate in poker. They only take a percentage of the pot, and the players play amongst themselves.
I see. I'm not a gambler, so I didn't know. That's very interesting to find out.
I never knew that.
Never knew that.
I wouldn't bet on that.
All right, Joe, good luck to you. May we have your selection here of A or B?
B.
B. B. The odds on B are 8-1. Now, if you had chosen A, it would have been 3-1, so. Here we go. Frank is such a rotten fisherman.
Really?
Yeah. It's very, very different. Frank is such a rotten fisherman, he has a picture on his wall of him posing next to a blank. It's a rotten fisherman, you see. Picture on the wall of him posing next to a blank.
What's in the paper?
What's in the paper, Charles?
It's a beautiful picture of Betty White and Dayton Anderson reunited in court. He forgives her, and she made the announcement that in the spring she will be again on the Carol Burnett Show and wear some of Gene Rayburn's clothes.
Now, wait a minute. Betty White is going to be on the Carol Burnett Show?
It says right here.
Does it say, is there a date up there?
Early spring.
Early spring.
I think that's wonderful. Thank you, and thank you for getting... Listen, may I have the other one? I don't look good in blue and orange.
Okay, you can wear the other one. Look, you haven't written an answer yet?
I was busy listening about Betty White being on the Carol Burnett
Frank is such
show.
A rotten fisherman, he has a picture on his wall of him posing next to a blank.
Your cue was late.
See what I got to put up with, Joe?
Yeah.
You think life is hard? Dealing poker all day for 28 years? Look at this. Frank is such a rotten fisherman, he has a picture on his wall of him posing next to a...
Sardine.
Sardine. He said sardine. Sardine.
Don't play against him. Sardine.
Sardine! I said the odds were 8-1. I'm wrong. Hello, Brett.
As I understand it, Carol Burnett is not thrilled at the thought of Betty White being on the show, but there's nothing she can do about it. Sardine.
Sardine. I am thrilled every time Betty White is on our show.
I took it a step further.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Can of tuna fish.
Can of tuna fish. Splendid answer. All right. Sardine is what we're after here, Barbara Rhodes.
Do you know there's no such fish as a sardine?
That's true. Now, this is interesting. You may categorize it as trivia.
Yes.
Tell them what sardines really are.
I don't know. They're just any little fish that fits in the can.
Whale sperm.
No. I mean, there's no fish called a sardine.
No, there is no fish called a sardine. Before the sardine gets into a can, it's called a herring.
Ah.
That's exactly true.
And it's west of Los Angeles.
That's true. Yeah. West of Los Angeles only.
Barring that fact, I wrote sardines.
Oh, look at this, Joe. I thought Joe was going to fall on his face with that answer. And he's so far he's gotten three.
Before sardine gets in the can, it's known as a herring.
Right.
Just the way you change your name when you get married, is that how he becomes a sardine?
That's right.
Marries a sardine can.
Well, they didn't know what to call it after they got it in the can, so they said, let's call it...
Then they call it canned herring.
I didn't start this whole... I didn't invent the whole thing. I don't know. I've never
I
canned a sardine
know
in my life.
I happen to know before they're called sardines, they're known as shrimps.
Shrimps? Yeah. Small fish.
That's their maiden name.
Right.
Maiden name.
What are you doing there?
I'll play these.
You'll go, all right.
Can of tuna.
Can of tuna. Listen, that's not bad for a first-round question. Three, Pat. Let's see if you can catch up. George is so tall, he's the only man in the world with a full-size tattoo of blank on his chest. He is so tall.
Oh, have I got it.
Only man in the world with a full-size tattoo of blank on his
Don't
chest.
Don't look at my answer.
Full-size tattoo...
Perfect.
Oh, yes.
Is that a wonderful
Right. Good. Oh, you're a good bunch. Splendid. Pat Geyer. George is so tall, he's the only man in the world with a full-size tattoo of blank on his chest.
Giraffe.
A giraffe. It's a
Maybe.
Tall animal. There are other tall things in this world. Avery, say one.
I didn't have a giraffe. I had Mount Etna.
Mount Etna. That's tall.
That's tall.
Yes.
That's a very good answer,
very
but
tall.
I still like my answer. I have to say that up front.
She likes her answer, so don't boo her.
That's right. Don't boo me because I like my... Wilt Chamberlain.
He's tall. That's a good answer. They like your answer.
Have
you got a good answer, too?
You betcha, kid.
Oh.
The Washington Monument.
That's tall. Anything tall is a good response here, Barbara. Show us something tall.
Stand up.
Very good. I think Brett Santer is wonderful.
Wilt Chamberlain.
Yeah. He's a little strange.
Pat is looking for a giraffe, Richard. Something, a tall animal.
Al Wilto.
Wilt Chamberlain. He's a tall animal. Yeah. Yes.
King Kong.
King Kong is tall. Yeah. So there we are at the end of round one. 3-0 score favor Joe Kennedy there. Round two coming up after this. Now, we don't have time to do another question, but we'll look forward to seeing both of you next time we are all gathered here together. Now, don't forget, you don't have an exact date when you're going to appear on the Carol Burnett Show, do you?
Well, we're just taping it now, so
I see.
It'll probably be
sometime soon.
March.
And what kind of goofiness are you going to do, do you know?
I'm not going to tell you yet.
Oh,
look.
Oh,
she's
all right.
She's cleaning up.
Yes.
She didn't mean she was acting on it. She meant she was working on it. Janet's arrest.
No, I don't believe that.
You
don't believe
ask her.
See, what's Carol Burnett's new time now? She's on what? Sunday
she's on
night?
Sunday night at 10.
Sunday night at 10 o'clock. Okay. Thank you, one and all. You are just splendid. I shall look forward to seeing all of your bodies next time you are gathered on this stage of these venerable, hallowed halls here. Gene Rayburn, goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Shotman production.